You made an interesting comment as you were discussing that there. You says, "Look, I understand," and you were going to be
Yeah, I
something.
understand. That's another one, yeah.
Yeah, literally, it says when you're looking at things, there's certain phrases. Now, I learned something from an individual a number of years back early on. It was actually quite good, and it was something that your viewers should actually think about and listen. Now, we're not here as conspiracists. We're basically here to point you things and to ask them to think. Now, if we say to your viewers just now, look, if we use the English language, now we can use the English language, but for clarification, what we will do to obtain the meaning is we will go to a dictionary, take the Oxford Dictionary. So we'll go there and they have a list of all the words you use. Now, every so often they take out a new word, so they've just added to it, right? So if we have an English language, and we have the Oxford Dictionary, and we also add on new words occasionally. Why is there a need for law dictionaries? We have loads and loads of law dictionaries, far more than the Oxford Dictionary, and there's new additions all the time. The reason for that is the words that we use and we refer to understand just now, which you mentioned, under the Oxford Dictionary, understand basically just means do you comprehend something? Now, under the system that they use, under the legal system, the legal dictionaries, the language is called legalese. It's completely separate from English. The words are identical, but the meanings are different. Now, in relation to the word understand, whereas in everyday life to men and women, it means comprehend, do you comprehend? Under their system, when a police officer is asked you if you understand, if you actually say yes, you've actually then became a slave. Because what the legalese term states is if you're confronted by an officer, when they say, do you understand? It literally means in their terminology, do you stand under my authority? So therefore, if you say to the constable, yes, I understand, that allows them, it creates joinder, which is a contractual agreement. It then allows them to prosecute you with their rules and to fine you or punish you. If you turn around and say to them, well, no, I'm sorry, I don't understand, the reply will come back, what do you mean you don't understand? I've just explained you've breached some act of parliament. They said, do you not understand? What you should do is turn around and say, no, I do not stand under your authority and I don't consent. Now that keeps you out of their system because it confirms that you're a living man or living woman and you have nothing to do with them. They therefore cannot enforce the legislation. That's the way it works. But it's all about names. Now, the term you also refer to, the term person. Person is literally a legal entity. He says, so you don't use that. You are either a living man or woman, or obviously you can adopt the positions that they have within their system. And that comes down to things like legal entities, the person, and various other things. But these are all legal terms to give them authority. You will note that. I've mentioned twice, I'll mention a couple of times, we'll do it again. The common law principles are basically cause no harm, loss, or injury to others, and ensure your honourable and contractual dealings. That is common law in a nutshell. It could be God's law and universal law, everything. They're all the same. They operate under key principles, and these are the principles. That's it. Under their system, they have hundreds of statutes, acts of parliament, legislation, and they've just introduced COVID legislation. Wonderful, we've got new legislation. But the point is, they are all rules in the statutes and acts, but they're only applicable to a person. They're not applicable to living men and women. You will note when they look and they refer to in the write-up the legislation, they will refer it always to a person. The person does this, the person must do this. It's a legal entity. It's not applicable to living men and women. So therefore, that's it. So you don't use the terminology they've got and you can stay out of the system. But they don't like that because they use this camouflage, they use trickery, and they use legalese to try to obviously entrap you and get joinder, which is create a contract. They've actually stacked in their system because a basic principle like your documentation, everything you have to identify yourself is in their system. It's to do with the person. So that gives them you're at a disadvantage straight away. Because if you produce ID or they ask you for ID and you produce it, it gives the legal fiction. So if they confirm, is this you? And then you look at your bank account and say, yes, straight away, you've got joinder. So you have to be very careful with what you do. It's all about trickery and it's all about contract.